Your life will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here to take you to.
Praise God, beloved. We thank God for this powerful week He has given to us. And all week we've been learning how to gird up the loins of our mind. We have a mind, and that mind has a loin. And we have learned three things: that we must be sober. Number two, we must hope to the end. You can't start expecting breakthroughs and quit. You must continue to hope until Jesus is revealed in every area of need. In other words, if you're believing for healing, you don't stop expecting one. You have to keep on expecting until Jesus shows up with healing, until He shows up with your miracle, whether it's a financial breakthrough, a relationship breakthrough, any manifest, even if it's a direct revelation of Himself, you hope to the end. And now you have to guard against the satanic weapons of lust, jealousies, and the like. Let's read 1 Peter chapter 1, 13 through 17. Wherefore, gird up the loins of your mind, be sober, and hope to the end for the grace that is to be brought unto you. Notice, a grace is brought to you at the revelation of Jesus Christ. A grace is brought to you. A grace manifest. You find yourself with a strength you never had, with wisdom you never had, with a mindset you've never had. The grace of God impacting your life. As obedient children, not fashioning yourselves according to the former lusts in your ignorance, but as He which hath called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation. Because it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. And if you call on the Father, who without respect of persons judgeth according to every man's work, pass the time of your sojourning here in fear, in the reverential fear of the Lord. See, beloved, the strength of your mind is rooted in sobriety, is rooted in never-ending hope, is rooted in the power of holiness. Holiness is strength. Holiness is power. Sin is a dissipation of our strength. Sin is a dissipation of our favor. Sin is a weakening of our minds. Hallelujah. The amazing thing, God says, be ye holy, for I am holy. In other words, it's a command, it's a charge. And when we take that position, we find ourselves in the realm of God. That is why, beloved, the Bible says, without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. You notice, He says, there will be a grace that will be birthed at the revelation of Jesus Christ. You see, no man shall see the Lord without holiness, but with holiness we shall see the Lord. With holiness, He will be revealed. With holiness, His power will show up. That never-ending hope will carry us. That expectation will carry us until the grace is revealed. Glory to God. It is a powerful thing. And it says, if we call on the Father, who without respect of persons judgeth according to every man's work, that we should pass the time of our journey here on the earth, this temporary existence, we should do it with reverence and godly fear. For our God, the Bible says, is a consuming fire. Beloved, it takes strength in the mind to stay holy. It takes strength in the mind to avoid the contaminations. It's coming from everywhere. Television, movies, video, computer, beaches, wherever. Sin is coming. Contaminations, temptations, everywhere. Our mind must be strong. Gird it up. That's a weapon against the enemy. So no matter how he attacks, no matter how he tries to discourage, no matter how he tries to deceive, we are strong enough. We war against him. We stand against him. We stay strong until Jesus comes, until that grace is revealed, until the manifestation of glory comes. That's the second agenda in this loins business. The physical loins, the loins of our mind, the strength of God making you impregnable. No depression, no seduction, no hopelessness, no discouragement, no unbelief. You stand strong until Jesus shows up. May we find you strong when we meet again on Monday next week to bring you another word from the throne as we learn our armaments of warfare for great victory. May God bless you. We love you. Pastor Chica. Bye-bye.
The Lord is waiting on you. Welcome to resurrection.
Welcome.
The Lord is waiting on you.